was a great meditation experience. You had fun watching us. We also had fun watching you. I felt that hunkara, as it was coming out of throat, was going straight out of mouth, and it was effortless. If I tried to interfere, sound would get diverted onto upper throat and was causing scratchy throat. Once I let go out straight, it was flowing beautiful. I feel so great and open. Can I do mundan? Oh, you. Oh God, what is this? How do we sustain the state of an unblocked Swadhisthana, the effect I felt after today's meditation? I have not felt by doing any technique on my own. I am sure your presence is the key. But now do I take this back with me? How do I take this back with me? Relax from the fear of how do I take this back with you. Wait. This 21 days is a long time. It will just be completely ingrained in your system. As on now, relax from this fear. If you carry this fear, this itself will become one more fear. Don't bother. Leave enlightenment now. That's enough. See, you are awakened. Early morning you wake up. Do you have a fear? Oh, I should not fall asleep and have dreams. What will happen again if I have some more nightmares? Do you have fear? You know, a nightmare can come, I'll come up. I'll wake up. So same way, you will not be afraid to fall back into this world and get up, because you know your true nature is this. See, once you know the true nature is this reality, you don't have fear of falling asleep and having a nightmare. Do you have the fear? No. You know, even if there is a nightmare, after a certain peak, you will wake up. Same way, once you are awakened, you know, even if you fall back into the same maya, if certain amount of pain or suffering is built, you will wake up. You will wake up. There is an automatic waking up system. Once you wake up, the automatic waking up system is there. You don't have to be afraid, oh, I'll fall back into the same maya, I'll fall into the same rut, nothing. You will never be a same person. You will never fall back into that same person. Don't worry. Who put the question? Rishi. Which would be more, the fear of the known or fear of unknown? I'm unable to gauge. Neither fear of known nor fear of unknown. Fear of fear is the most horrible fear. Fear that you may have fear or you will have fear is the most horrible fear. Understand? Any definite thing does not create fear in you. You know for sure, next year you are not going to become Bill Gates. You are not afraid of that. But there is a possibility you may gain little money or less money. You have your border. Within that only your fear will be playing. Fear, you may have the... See, fear itself within your possibility only. Within your possibilities only. You know for sure there are certain things in your life. You will never be afraid of that. Those few certain things. Death is a possibility. It is not certainty. See, death incident itself is certainty. But the time and the way in which it will happen, all those things are possibilities. We are afraid because the possibility, the freedom is there. The possibility is there. So the worst fear is fear that you may have fear. That's the worst fear. Nothing else is worse than this fear. Known, unknown, even known things can create fear. Even unknown things sometimes may not create fear. But the fear that you may have fear. Afraid of fears, that is the worst fear. Especially these phobias and all is fear of fears only. The moment you have an idea, you may have this phobia, you will start having that effect of that phobia. When I was on the Himalayas Yatra this year, I was aware of overcoming many fear, especially on the way to Yamunotri. Since then, I feel most of my fears I experience as fear strokes rather than their generalized fear. Is there a qualitative difference between fear strokes and vague generalized fear? Yes, there is a qualitative difference. No doubt about it. How to manage fear strokes? They are more paralyzing than other fears. Sivaranjani. First thing, man, you cannot manage the fear strokes or fear just falling in tune with it. It's okay, what can be done, this is the way I am. Acceptance is the only way, because it is inevitable. This, the moment or the fear is inevitable, you understand? Acceptance is the only way to conquer inevitable things. The fear in you or the fear stroke which is happening in you are more inevitable things. Accept, suddenly you will see the quality of fear disappears. The moment you accept, let your whole body tremble, shiver, let you have the fear stroke and nausea, don't fight with it. When you don't fight with it, you will see the fear is a deep peace. You are retracting, you are contracting, you are settling into yourself, you are coming back to the home. When you fight, only then you start creating more problem. With fear, no fight. Fighting won't help. Just accept. When the fear stroke happens, accept. Leave it. That is the only way. When I was doing the Hunkara meditation, I felt very light-headed and I had to stop early. When I was placing my awareness in the Swadhisthana Chakra, I felt peace and then intense agitation. I wanted people to stop right away. Then I had to remind myself of the beings, nature of Nityanandam. Then peace followed. But then the second time the agitation came, I started shaking like when I was caught in an elevator. Even after the meditation I was shaken and felt like throwing up. Then now I feel light. It's a process. It's a cleansing process. Swamiji, why does the mind or personality keeps forgetting the being's core Nityanandam? Thank you for all your help and love and blessings. This is just a simple process. I told you, this is expected. Trembling and shivering and all those things are expected. Should one have fears or not? Is it natural to have fears? Can one overcome fears? You need to understand this question first. Fear is your nature, but not towards any object. Object is artificial. Having fear is your nature. Connecting that fear with an object is societal. Understand? When you take birth, you have pure fear, which is responsible for your rest, peace. See, unless you have fear, you will not even be able to sleep. Even sleeping means coming back happens because of the pure fear. Pure fear is responsible for you coming back and sleeping. Please understand, connecting that fear with some object is societal. A fear of this, fear of that, fear of this, that is societal. But pure fear is natural. So don't bother about the pure fear, let it be there. For example, if a snake comes, you think I will not run? I will run. Pure fear, simply protecting itself. Pure fear protects itself and it is spontaneous, it is powerful. But the fear of something, that's where starts all messing up. All difficulties, complications. So pure fear is natural, you don't have to overcome, let it be there. But fear of objects, accept, then you will see. See, the moment you accept your fear, fear loses its power to frighten you. Fear loses its power to frighten you. As long as you fight, resist, only then your fear has a power to frighten you. Once you stop resisting, your fear has no power to frighten you. Would you explain more how it works to have fear or desire without an object? Would you explain more how it works to have fear or desire without an object? Oh, this is a nice question. You are asking essence of living enlightenment. See, when you have a pure desire, you will see kind of a excitement for no reason. You just, many times you can see early morning, you will have that excitement. Early morning,
You don't have any exact idea what you want to do, but you will jump out of the bed. And you just want to come out. And you don't know what to do. There is no particular object or straight, direct idea what to do. But you are just bubbling, overflowing. This is what I call, how many of you have experienced even once this feeling? Surely you would have experienced. This is what I call pure desire without object. And same way, for no reason, suddenly you will feel depressed and you will feel like going into your room and locking yourself. You will try to find out what is the reason, no reason. And you feel like you want to lock yourself up in the room. I think this everybody has felt every day, I think. You would have felt again and again. This is what I call fear for no cause, fear for no reason. So it is natural. This cycle is natural. These energy cycles are natural. You don't have to be bothered at all about this. All you need to do, when you have an object connected to your fear or desire, especially when you have an object connected to your fear, accept. That acceptance itself transforms. What can be done? Nothing can be done. No other technique can help except acceptance with fear. Because more you fight, more you empower the fear. Fear is such, any idea you bring it to overcome, it will be shaken. You will never be able to do. I have seen so many people trying so many ideas. People start chanting Ramakrishna, 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 nothing works. See, because you are shouting, your attention may be diverted. I have seen people when they walk alone, that is the time they will call all devatas. Rama, Krishna, Govinda, Shiva, Vishnu, all gods. And they feel, oh, you see, when you are loudly calling, your attention is diverted. So that moment you may not feel the fear. That does not mean you are out of the fear. Again, next day when you are walking alone, the fear is there. So no Ramakrishna Govinda will work at that time. The simple acceptance and allowing the trembling, allowing that fear, allowing that suffering to take over you, just take bath in that fear. Just let you be showered with that fear and go into that. Go 2-3 times into that fear. You will see next time it's not touching you anymore. This is the permanent solution. Acceptance is the permanent solution to transform the fear. Otherwise, any other technique you use, it will be only diverting the fear. It will only be diverting. You will never be able to come out of it. I was having more sensation while doing Swadhisthana meditation. Is it because I am having more fear? Don't bother about that. It's just process connected to bio-memory. You don't have to have so much of worry. I have more fear, I think. Fear of losing master's devotion or faith. Does it relate to object? Is it a form of energy? Understand? You don't have to see if your faith is built, if your devotion is built on your experiences, you don't have to have the fear of losing it at all. If it is not built on your experiences, let it be lost immediately. It has no value. It should not be there. Please understand, the devotion towards the master, the faith towards the master is like an intimate relationship. It's a beautiful intimate relationship. So let it be built on your experience. How you feel connected, how you connect with him, how you relate with him. Let that be built on your personal experience. If it is built on your personal experience, it will never be lost. It will never be lost. If it is not built on your personal experience, then let it be lost now. For example, when you see how you connect with him, when you directly listen somebody who has connected with him or experience, when this kind of direct experience happens, when you listen to somebody who is really closely lived with me, and I can say, even when you listen an experience of somebody with whom you feel really connected, that becomes your own experience. For example, yesterday I heard, today morning, my secretary was telling, he was sitting with you guys for last night. Yesterday night he was sitting. When you really connect, His experience also becomes part of you. Suddenly you see, you don't have to live around me for 5 years to have that same connection. What he had, what connection he had with me, he is having with me, with 5 years being around me, just intensely imbibing it or feeling it, you have that same connection. So that also becomes your experience. So if it is, everything is built on your experience, your understanding, then you don't have to have the fear of losing it. If it is not yours, if it is not your clarity, then even if I directly show you some miracle, directly show you something, you will have doubts. So it's like a strength and the integrity of the person. If you don't have that strength and integrity, let the faith and devotion be lost now. At least you will know you don't have faith, so you will start creating the integrity. You will start becoming integrated. You will start becoming centered. If the personality is not deep enough, even if you have faith, it's not worthy. If a personality is deep enough, you don't have to bother. The devotion which you have will never be lost. It will be there forever. And you know, I am there for you. While I did that, maybe these kind of questions you guys should ask the senior swamis. They will be able to answer more from their experience. See, now what I spoke about this faith and devotion, whatever is said and done, I never lived with a master. So I exactly experientially do not know what you guys go through. I know usually what happens in the mind. So I can answer. But these guys experientially go through what you go through. So these guys can give you much better answers. In some places they are better than me. While I did the Swadhisthana meditation, I felt brave instead of fear. So I tried to feel the fear of death. No, you don't have to try and all. So whatever is there will come out. So don't bother. I told fear will come usually because people suppress fear only. So I tried to feel the fear of death, but none was there. I wanted it. Then my body felt flooded with heat, sweat poured off. It was very intense, but I enjoyed it a lot. I wanted it to last forever. I don't think that was this was fear. You are on the right track. Debbie? Who? So, you are on the right track. You don't have to expect or create fear, ma. If it comes out, okay. I think if it is not there, enjoy it. That was a very powerful meditation. I felt an incredible energizing effect from everyone reciting the mantra. Then when we stopped, it was like a black hole in my Swadhisthana region. It felt like you are being rushed into mine. Then there was no distinction between my being, yours, or anyone else. Premanathan. Wonderful. See, who? Yes. Like this, one meditation, even one glimpse in one meditation is enough. You will see now, the breakthroughs will be continuously happening. The first breakthrough is important. It's a real breakthrough. It's a real opening up. Once that one opening happens, you will see every meditation adds, opens a new dimension, new level. You have any questions? Yes. You can please be seated.
I had an opening today. And I thought that now I'm going to experience Shiva
Swarupa. Wonderful. Actually, these words will become an experience. Wonderful. So this first opening happens usually after a few meditation techniques. Then you will see every meditation will have a new opening. The first opening only will take little time. Once that happens, like this, what he is telling that time, I could feel very clearly there was no difference between my being and every other's beings. That's what I call, I am not only alive in this skin, I am alive in this skin also. So like this one glimpse, then you will see, suddenly you are able to connect with all meditations, and suddenly you are able to connect with all the words I am uttering. Suddenly everything falls in place. That is what I call awakening. It is no more words. It is no more theories. I am not proposing any theories anymore. See, till you have that first opening, whatever I am talking, you may believe, okay, when he says, I can't tell anything, he doesn't, he may be knowing more than me. And you may be believing. It's more or less words, words, words. But once one or two openings starts happening, then everything is solid truth. You will drink me. Whatever is coming out, you will just imbibe. You will just swallow.
During the Hunkar meditation, I suddenly developed a severe headache, which disappeared totally after some time. I felt like jumping and dancing after the whole meditation is over. Means the whole body, the pure fear is spreading. See, pure fear is energy. It's a deep peace. When the deep peace is experienced, you feel so much rejuvenation. The rejuvenation and joy. The rejuvenation is felt only by pure fear. Whenever fear happens to you, understand, you are getting rejuvenated. Where does courage come from and how is it related to fearlessness? When you experience pure fear and relax, the rejuvenating feeling which you feel is what is courage. In Nitya Yoga, during visualization, however hard I try, I am not able to get photo of my body into mind. It is blank. How do I get awareness of my body? Maybe first one or two days you will have this problem. After that it won't be a problem. Because you will just be able to make your frame. When you close your eyes, you see the negative of you. That is enough. That itself will help you. Not related to above question. Does only human beings get enlightened? Unless an enlightened master or avatar purusha intervenes, only human beings can get enlightened. If he intervenes, he can liberate even animals. Ramana Maharshi did. Ramakrishna did. Like this great incarnation, they have interfered and they have done. It's an exemption. But as a rule, human beings only get enlightened. Even devatas don't get enlightened. Even the devatas, if they have to get enlightened, they have to come down to the planet Earth as a human being. Only then they can get enlightened. Indra, Vayu, Varuna, all the guys, if they want to have enlightenment, they have to come here. Indraloka is nothing but a more or less like a 7-star hotel. Understand? No, that's all. So, that's all. It's a little luxurious. Otherwise, there is nothing special about it. You will feel bored. If you are depressed, even if you are staying in 7-star hotel, what is the use? No, really, I tell you, all devatas are depressed. No, really. What will you do? So much of women and wine and how many days you will enjoy? 2-3 days, after that, all devatas are depressed. Don't bother. I am telling you from experience. All devatas are depressed. See, in the planet Earth, I have seen only 2 people are happy, living blissfully. One, enlightened beings. Another one, people who are living around enlightened beings. That's all. Nobody else. Nobody else is blissful. In the whole cosmos, nobody is blissful. Except enlightened beings and people who are living around enlightened beings. When they live around enlightened beings, they just live in his light. They just experience his light. So they are living happily. Otherwise, Indraloka, Chandraloka and all, just one more luxurious hotel. Taj Hotel, Meridian, Lee Meridian, like that, that's all. Little bigger Lee Meridian. Little bigger Oberoi, that's all. And suddenly terrorists also attack, you don't know. That's what we call demons. Suddenly these fellows come and land. Ravana comes and lands. The Chanda comes and lands. Munda comes and lands. That is what becomes Purana. That's all. See, now the police army has been sent. Their Devasena will be sent. The army of gods will be sent with Subramanya. And he goes and kills all the people and comes back. So this is the same drama happening for eternally. These are some of the wonderful experiences. The Swadhisthana meditation was really an amazing one. As I filled in circles in our seats, I experienced 2 things at different moments. First, I was getting into the grove. I suddenly felt with a shivalingam. As I continued to spin, I felt one with Shiva. Sensation was that I felt it was large cobra. As we continued to spin and put chakra awareness, it made me think of doing aarti and ringing the bell. Maybe you are a person who is devotion based. Try to go to aarti whenever you find time and do puja. That will make you completely connected with that energy. Gauri, try to do puja. These are all the ways you will discover your own technique. Now, when you feel connected to that, then that is your technique. You should try. See, puja may not work for all, but for some people, it will straight away connect. It will straight away connect and nothing will be needed. Simple puja is enough. They will be in ecstasy. They will be just living enlightenment. So, try it. You mentioned Indraloka, Devaloka, Vaikuntha. Can you please? No, Vaikuntha is different. You see, Vaikuntha is an enlightened space. Don't connect Vaikuntha with the Indraloka and Devaloka. Vaikuntha and all you can reach only by pure devotion. You cannot reach by doing some yajna, doing some nonsensical ritual. But Indraloka and Devaloka you can reach by ritual. You can just, if you just make enough money to go there, you can go. But for Vaikuntha you need a special visa. Even money won't do. Vaikuntha and Kailash and all, it's a different space which can be reached only by the purity of the being. But Indraloka and all these things, you don't need purity of the being or any tapas is not required. What is the whole cosmos all about? How it rises and why it rises and what is play going on? Related to this, how does the individual soul move between worlds? I have read some things about this in autobiography of Yogi, but it's not very clear. You have also not talked about any of this in any of the videos that are in YouTube. Who put the question? I'll talk. You have 21 days. I'll talk all these things very slowly. We'll keep all those questions for waiting list. See, first I want to do, give a solid experience to you. Then all this casual chat we can do later on. During the last session, constantly seeing graphical elements, some logos, some posters with the design elements. Kavya, you are a designer, na? So... Can you please explain me what is pure fear and pure greed? I still am confused. I think energy going up, overflowing for no reason is pure greed. Energy settling back, rewinding for no reason is a pure fear. Understand this. When there is no object is involved, it is pure fear and greed. When there is, you see, when the energy is just overflowing, if you think because of this object or this memory or this experience I am overflowing, it becomes greed, ordinary greed. When the energy is contracting, if you think because of this object or this thing I am contracting, it becomes ordinary fear. If you know the signs, when you are exploding and when you are contracting, you will very clearly know it's a pure fear and pure greed. I am only creating unnecessary outer fear and outer greed. It's a liberating experience. In doing the fear meditation, the part where just sitting in silence at the end, I felt this intense energy full of my space. That's what, the pure peace, the pure fear. Pure fear can't even be called as fear. Pure fear is settling energy. When it is connected to some object only, it is called fear. Was the energy coming from you or from within me? Within you and me is one and the same. Relax. Inside you, me are not two different energies. They are same space. Why am I having this experience of this energy? How do I dive deeper into the experience? You don't have to worry about anything. Why am I having? How do I dive deep? Just enjoy, live it. You will see, it settles. Please explain the significance of my experience during the Swadhisthana meditation. Halfway down the meditation, I would see the chakra as a ring of silent darkness and felt a sensation of soothing vibration at that. Wonderful. Good. As I was doing the hip rotation, reciting Hunkara, I felt and saw a cap of white light. Sahasrara and brow center. The ring of silent darkness. Wonderful. Can vision be restored using meditation, yoga, healing? You can create and restore visions through yoga. In the meditation, I could feel my inner space that I was getting disappearing into a void, but at the same time getting energized. Is this what you mean by the black hole? Yes. That's exactly what I mean by the word black hole. During times when mind was in silence, desiring. Dasarathi, what is the question? Silence and next word, during. Exhalation, I was able to pass blissful energy through hands and legs. That's what the pure fear, when it spreads all over the body, it's energy. When I was doing second Swadhisthana meditation, awareness constantly pulling into Ajna Chakra area. After meditation, I felt like floating bottom of the sea. Wonderful.